All right, next GT3 RS project that I've been putting off for a long time, I finally am feeling caught up in life, is I wanna, and I hate to say this, I wanna try another exhaust. So we'll show you what it looks like, but one of the major cons to going catless is that the entire rear section of the car is starting to yellow, especially a white car. I didn't notice it as much on my blue GT3, my 2014, but I'm really noticing it on, and I only have maybe 4,000 miles with the RS and the Dundon exhaust. And the Dundon exhaust is incredible. You know, it makes probably 35 horsepower at the wheels and sounds amazing. And I'll probably end up doing the Dundon street system, but I've been friends with the AWE guys for years, probably 10, 11 years now. I would talk to Jesse about doing their switch path exhaust, which, by the way, this exhaust here, this is exactly what I wanted them to make in 2014 when I was doing my 12 or 13 different exhaust iterations. So I almost feel compelled to try this. AWE has always been kings of drone battling. Like they're always great about making exhausts that don't drone. And so this setup is gonna be very different, and I'll show you how it looks versus the Dundon. It'll be very different in that we're doing factory headers. So we're going to lose some power here. Factory headers, and then we've gotten rid of the side muffler. So this is a side muffler delete. And when you do this type of full side muffler delete option with a lot of exhaust, it ends up being drone crazy and really, really obnoxiously loud and just not good. So we're going to see how this goes. I'm assuming if AWE launched this exhaust, that we're not going to have drone issues, and so we'll see. Now we're going to pick up quite a bit of restriction here. I mean, I'll show you the difference between the Dundon side mufflers and Dundon center muffler and this center section, but we're going to see how this goes. And this is what a lot of guys want to do. So here's your typical center bypass. A little bit different. This is AWE's iteration of it or version of it. But normally you wouldn't do side muffler deletes and center muffler delete. And so I'm really interested to see how this goes, where we do side and center muffler delete to retain the factory headers and cats. And I'm interested to see how it sounds. I hope it's still nasty without the drone. Only one way to find out is to pull the exhaust off and try it, and then see if I end up back with, which I'll likely end up doing because of the power gains, see if I end up going back to a Dundon catted version of their equal length headers. So anyway, let's set the cameras up. I'm gonna start tearing apart the Dundon exhaust. I don't need to take the rear bumper off. The only real reason to take the rear bumper off with a GT3 exhaust or a 911 exhaust is to get the side mufflers out. So it would certainly be easier if I took the rear bumper off, but I'd rather avoid that if I can and just drop the exhaust down and put the new one in. So I'm gonna see how it goes, but I think I'm gonna leave the rear bumper off or on and just remove the bottom plate and just work through this one step at a time. So let's get rolling. All right, so first step, take the plate off. I need to go get some oil. I'll change the oil while we're under here. Do AMSOIL 5W30 or 5W40. I think it's 5W40. Sure would be nice to have a rolling cart, but then the problem with having a rolling cart, then I gotta put it somewhere. I need a bigger place. Much bigger place. That's all of them. All right, now we have full access to change the oil, drop everything out. So I think first thing I'll do, I'm gonna loosen these here, and then I'll loosen these. I'm gonna hit this with some free all, some penetrating oil just to keep from ruining the nuts. That way I can sell this thing. So if you're a GT3 guy and you want a Dundon race, I'm up for selling it. Since when I do likely go back to the Dundon exhaust, I'll probably be doing the catted version. I'm getting smarter in my old age to do good practice by using something like this to help from jacking all this stuff up. All right, so what do I want to do first here? So I'm gonna loosen these. I think it's a 13 mil. Planned ahead this time, 13 mil deep socket. Those off. What I should do before I get crazy here, I'm gonna cut these vacuum or remove the vacuum line so that I don't yank it out of the car. I'm gonna take the O2 sensors off. They're 23. Let's see how good I'm getting at this. Probably not very. Yeah. So remember, green goes towards the front of the car. Help me remember that. Green goes front. Oh yeah, I meant green to the back. Gray to the front. Well, we're definitely gonna get it wrong. We got enough videos we can go back and look at if we had to. But I like to remove the O2 sensors first, just so that I don't end up, again, pulling them out of the car when I get hasty and forget. The car is probably going, because it's been catless for so long, the car is going to go nutty too for a little while. I learned that lesson on my 2014. I put the stock exhaust back on, sent it up to the dealership, and it had like 17 codes, all kinds of misfire codes that needed to be cleaned up and cleared. The dealership freaked out. They almost didn't want to do the deal. It was bad. I won't fear that this time. So drive around the block, clear the codes, drive around the block, clear the codes, and we'll be good. Green goes back. Tires low, still look okay. I'm getting there. Probably another 3,000 miles or so. Get a new set of rears. Fronts last a lot longer.
How much do the tires cost?
Yeah, like $500 a piece, something like that. High fours, low fives. Gotta pay to play. But I was mentioning this in another video about how amazing these cars are to work on. It's so much different than a Ferrari or McLaren or something else. Like, a lot of guys are like, oh, you get nervous about working on your expensive Porsche. And at first, yes, I thought I would have to have some special oil change and have to hire somebody to work on it, but they're so darn easy to do. So easy to work on that, I mean, anyone can do it. I'm gonna do these by hand right here. Probably gonna be a little too tight for my little impact anyway. I'm gonna need to get a wobble, I think. Should really only need to loosen these, not completely remove them. This is where not removing the bumper works against you. So let's try putting a little wobble extension on here. That'll work. These top ones are getting a little trickier. And then we got one on the very top, which I don't know that I'm gonna be able to reach. Yep, got it. Cool, so I think I'm gonna be able to do this without taking the bumper off.
on the other side.
I'm gonna just fit this in here. Be a little smarter about this. There's that.
There's six of these. I'm gonna get my new gray hat all jacked up.
This makes me a little nervous when the car's shaking. And then the one last one on the top. Man, I don't know what I'm gonna do with myself when I've get all these mental projects, all these things I've had in the back of my head for some of them 6 months now or longer. I don't know what I'm gonna do with myself. I'm gonna have to create all kinds of other chaos. It's amazing how much that penetrating oil does to clean this up. These clamps kind of hung up on there. Okay, loose there. Need a new glove. That would have been a blood hand for sure. Let's do it the way I normally do it. Let's take let me see if I can get the side muffler out here while I'm at it first. Clear up some space. The side muffler and center muffler might have to come out in one piece. That. Let me just drop the center muffler down. Oh shoot. I'm gonna put these on backwards. Crap. So I think it's a 6mm up there. Crap. I'm gonna take these off. The way they're supposed to go. So the problem is I've got a 6mm bolt, but the bolt is on top. If I can fit this in there. Dang it, idiot. Gosh, this would take 2 seconds if I would have just flipped it around and zip it right out. No, I always have to do everything wrong. Trying to avoid. Jeez.
I like using the free all, but then it makes a mess.
Dude, what the heck? Am I using the wrong size? I don't think these are 12s.
I think these are 12 mils.
I think that's why I've been messing them up. Shh. The whole time. I got two left.
All right. Header number two. All right, let me put the headers back in. I need help. I can't believe I was taking these all off of the wrong size. I'm pretty sure I've always done these at 13. I can't believe I'm putting factory headers back on the car. Header number two. What the flip? Can't. Frickin' hands are too slippery.
Yeah, I'm telling you, there are two of these. They're 13 millimeters. How is that even possible?
Oh, two sensors go back in.
Gray goes towards the front of the car. So I turn this in reverse. A bunch.
Green goes in the cat, gray goes in the back. I think. I hope. What does it seem like I got that wrong?
Green was in the back.
I know, but was it different on the factory? See, it feels like the gray goes right here. I mean, I know on the aftermarket. I'm right. Stop questioning myself. Good.
Okay. Now, let me start doing the AWE. First thing I gotta do is take these E12s off and put those brackets back in place. All right, so I took these brackets off because we didn't need it with a Dundon exhaust. So I'm gonna have to put them back on. These are E12 external or internal Torx. All right, so which way do these go? I don't remember. Oh, it, like in normal Porsche fashion, it only goes on one way, so you can't really mess it up. I'm gonna have to read some directions. This is really gonna suck if this is not the right exhaust. So, trying to test fit this thing, because I didn't take the bumper off, it's gonna make it harder to put back together, but I think we're gonna be okay. So all I gotta do is take this thing and put it on the ground. It's like I can't get any leverage without it pinching my freaking hand. I don't know if this got tweaked in shipping or what. Make sure that I'm putting this on correctly. Do I have these on the wrong side? No, that's correct. Oh, I see how that goes. Okay, we don't have to drill any holes. Gee whiz, man. Oh wait, I need to go the other way with it. Okay. Here we go. Okay, that's on. And it looked like it's pretty centered up there.
Yeah, it's tilted up a little bit, but I mean, it's on there.
Okay, so.
We're
gonna tie this one on. Yeah. Okay. I'll basically hold the whole thing up.
Okay. That's not tight at all.
Yeah, I know. I don't want it too tight.
I mean, they're the same.
Well, it's like the angle.
Yeah, this
side. See how this one's, the flange is going narrower on this side. This one's narrower on this side.
Yeah, that's the way it's supposed to be, so we gotta flip it around.
Which one? Because that seems to fit better.
Yeah, this is correct.
Okay, so this one needs to be flipped.
I don't like to do these with the machine because these bolts heat up and they snap. That's a good solid seal right there. Okay, now let's check our left to right. Tips look a lot better than I thought they were gonna look. Well, I mean, the factory opening is a little off on these. I think it looks pretty good. We don't really have a whole lot of adjustment, so. I mean, but we're pretty good left to right.
That looks good from the side here.
Yeah, all right. All right, so now I'm gonna go around. I'm gonna tighten the headers first. So we'll do those. So I'm gonna 12 millimeter. So I'm gonna go around and just kind of tighten everything up. Okay, tight. Next up, so we ended up not needing these brackets, so I'm gonna put these back in here. I'll explain what I was talking about here in a minute. Those brackets were the factory brackets that held the OE side mufflers on. This is so not bad though, like it's so much more enjoyable when the air conditioning on a lift, even though the lift is a tiny bit too short. I need to get some taller lift blocks. So if I can get like an extra couple of inches, then I could stand straight up. So these we want to get tight, but we need to be careful. These bolts heat up and they break. I say that is not going to leak. Exhaust is certainly well put together. Man, really, really solid here. I really wanted this one to be facing down, but it'll be all right. We got plenty of room there to torque these. So this is probably like a, I think it's a 15. Yeah, 15. I love these type of AccuSeal connections. I don't know, I just feel like they give me a better seal. I know a lot of people prefer V-bands, but I feel like this is the best way to go. That's tight. At least get them set into position. See, I messed up and did this one backwards. I can't, yeah, see, I can't do it that way.
I can't do it.
I don't want it hanging down either.
Can you take the...
Yeah, I guess I could just take it apart. Huh? Now is going to be the hard part. I like that symmetry instead of random. These are tightened to 40 foot-pounds, so we just calculate that here. There's 32, 35, 38.6. 39, 40. Perfect. All skill. All right, so now we need to figure out.
since they only sent me one. Looks like on this side we might be okay, just use a washer.
So, we're supposed to have two of these, because this goes on the back right here and keeps the rear section attached to the car. I'm almost inclined to cut these things off and leave it. I mean, the thing's not going anywhere. Yeah. I just want to get the cutoff wheel and zip, and cut those things off. And that'll hold it in place. Oh, there it is. Blood hand. Never fails. A little ghetto, but you gotta do what you gotta do. I mean, it was taped to the darn exhaust. There's just only one of them. So this is the way it's supposed to go with this bracket. You've got to be kidding me. Well, that's not getting the washer. You're like, see, that's why Swiss Trax is no good. Because I drop a washer one time a year and I'd have to pop that tile up to get it. Now I need a 13 and a 13. I think. Tell me that's a 12. It is. What's up with a 12? I don't use a 12 of anything in my life. What the flip? Are you kidding me? You've got to be kidding me. Okay, I was about to flip my lid. That'll work. It's a big old fender washer. This is what I can't. So let's do it the other way this time. That'll keep that nice and tight. So we just did a couple of washers here. Although, you know, it should look like this. Or it looks like that, but it'll do the job. So let me put these on. I don't need this anymore. I'm gonna shorten these up quite a bit. All right, so let's put the valves on. These little zip ties, a little sharper, a little smaller zip ties we'll put in order to hold this in place. When I say sharper, I just mean thinner. So it'll create a little bit more of a little more of a bite than a fatter one would on this type of connection. Done. Headers are tight, my AccuSeal connections are tight, vacuum lines are on. Last thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna wipe this down first, and then I'll put my tips on. I'll lower the car down a little bit, do our tips. We gotta add a little anti-seize to the clips or the tips. All right, so let me clean this thing up here. A little IPA. So people always yell at me for doing this, but if you don't do this, then you'll end up with fingerprints all over your exhaust from where you were touching it. So we've got to clean it. Otherwise, I guess if you don't care, but and this type of exhaust doesn't matter as much, but. I just don't want to see my fingerprints all over it. It looks good. I think this is going to sound pretty good. It's not going to make any power, I don't think, but it's going to work out just fine. All right, let's get the tips done. Anti-seize. It's weird that this doesn't have nuts on it. I guess it doesn't need it. So Don't go crazy on the old Optimal or anti-seize, but we do want to put a little on here. Not sure why we're doing it. The AccuSeals, I find, don't tend to rust. That's probably more than I should put on there. Not sure why AWB recommends doing this and not the other bolts, but maybe they did recommend the other bolts, I just didn't listen. So our tips are something we definitely want to make sure we wipe down after we palm the heck out of these things. Yeah, this clamp system is way better. I lost on my S4 before I lost my tip. Like, it went flying off the back of the car. So we're gonna, since this one's looser, we're gonna set this one up first, and then we'll match the other one to it. It's a little lower, but just the way it grabs, we really don't have a choice. You won't notice it when it's on the ground. I'd say those aren't going anywhere. That's a good old dishonest day's work right there, man. I just wish I had an option for matte black instead of chrome black. All right, so good news is I didn't have to take the bumper off, which you would. So let's say you're going from stock to AWE, you're gonna have to take the rear bumper off in order to get the side mufflers out, because they won't clear the heat shields on the side. But in my case, because we'd already taken the side mufflers off before, I didn't have to do that. I didn't have to remove it. So that made the project quite a bit easier. I mean, it probably takes an hour to take it off and put it in, and another hour to put it back on. And that's assuming you've done it before. If you haven't done it before, it can take quite a bit longer to do that. So again, this is an experiment for me to test out and see how the AWE does as a simpler exhaust versus the more sophisticated, you know, long tube headers, equal length headers from Dundon. So there's a good possibility I'll end up, I don't know, we'll see what happens. I'll probably end up with a Dundon again, because I don't know how this is gonna go from a power perspective. I don't know if I'm gonna notice the power difference. The AW claims 19 horsepower difference, but that's at peak. So I don't know, we'll see. We're gonna test it out. I'm not gonna drive it today because I gotta go get oil. And I'd like to get the oil changed prior to putting the plate back on, you know, the bottom plate. But yeah, the install went great. We're gonna fire it up here in a minute, so we'll definitely get you some audio clips of it. Yeah, the car's gonna run like crap for a little while.
It's
Standing behind the camera was a mistake.
Will these my lugs? Yeah, perfect. We can put our spacers on. As I get a chance to go out and do some flybys and see what it sounds like outside the car, I mean, that's the most fun part to me. So anyway, I like to, as I'm putting my tools away, I like to wipe them down and keep them clean. This is the time to do that. But look how cool this is. It's the coolest thing in the world. So what I'll also do as I fire it up is just double check, make sure I don't have any leaks. It'd be really hard to get a leak the way that this thing's set up. Again, not nearly as sophisticated as doing headers. A lot simpler, which means a lot less possibility of leaking or vibrating or anything like that. So we should be okay there. But anyway, thanks for watching this install, and I'll catch you shortly, probably doing some flybys with the car. I'll catch you on the next one. More RS stuff. We got to work on getting the yellowing off the back. We'll find out if I got to pull the PPF off or if I can repair it. So this will be a fun little test. So anyway, thanks for watching this one. Stay tuned for more crazy.